The Met Office is noting a drastic change in the traditional weather pattern. For example, the dry season is normally January to June, while the wet season spans the period July to December. Yet, according to the Met Office, a study revealed that the month of April was the wettest. As far as the office is concerned, this has implications for Saint Lucia. For example, less fresh water and temperature fluctuations. Met officials say they are uncertain as to Saint Lucia's level of preparedness to deal with the changing weather patterns.
I'm not sure if we are really prepared for it. But what I can say is that I believe it is with us, and we will have to deal with it. We have to put measures in place to deal with it. It has implications for water levels. With climate change, we expect to have less fresh water. We expect temperatures to rise, and people will have to, you know, put measures in place to cope with these differences.
The local Met Office says it will continue to work with partner agencies to ensure that adequate and advance warnings are given ahead of an impending severe weather. Met officials went on to explain the difference between climate change and climate variability.
Climate change is a slower, much slower process than climate variability. We could look at variability as looking at a tolerance level. See, you expect things to happen well. On average, you find things deviating from the average, right? So that's what we call variability. So sometimes you find things above the average, and sometimes you find things lower than the average. But the climate change is that when you find the average moving in a particular direction, say global warming, you find the average, the whole average temperatures shifting, say, from what it was to maybe 1 or 2 degrees higher than it was.
Even the Christmas Eve trough last year was considered highly unusual, since it occurred in December after the hurricane season was declared officially over. The trough dumped heavy rainfall on the island, triggering floods and landslides, resulting in widespread damage to homes, crops, and infrastructure, and causing at least 6 deaths. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.